Hello everyone. My name is Ethan Snoksin Basusu. I'm study master degree in oral and maxillofacial surgery in faculty of dentistry at Chulalongkorn University. My advisor is Professor Kanit Thaneswaran and my co-advisor are Professor Sunisa Rojanavipha, Professor Isala Kao Kamnerpong and Professor Kitti Siriwat. Today I would like to present my research entitled Survey about dentist proposal for tooth autotransplantation pilot study. This is my outline. Let's begin with introduction. When present with edentulite in the mouth, dentists have a number of options which can be used for dental substitution, such as bridge, orthodontic treatment, tooth autotransplant, dental implant, or removable denture. These are comparable according to functional and aesthetic purpose. Tooth autotransplantation is the treatment for replacing the single edentulite area by the patient's own tooth, maybe from non-functional tooth such as impact or embedded tooth, but it is not popular as dental implant or other choice. Even though there are many advantages of tooth autotransplantation, which include using natural teeth, some donor tooth have a chance to revascularize, can be performed in going patient and can be moved by orthodontic board, especially it can gain aesthetic and cost-effective results. However, there are some limitations such as it is a sensitive technique which requires a high skill level of the dentist and a proper donor tooth. There are many technologies that simplify tooth autotransplantation technique and increase success rate. According to cost research in 2013, in a study of 1,250 transplanted cases between 1924 to 2011, the success rate and survival rate of tooth autotransplantation were found to be 79% to 100% and 56% to 100% respectively. They follow up for 1 year and up to 41 years. Similarly, from previous study, it has been reported that survival rate of tooth autotransplantation is more than 90%, whether it is in mature or immature donor teeth. Even in the faculty of dentistry at Chulalongkorn University revealed that only 40 cases of this treatment were conducted over the last 10 years. According to previous medical and dental study, the factor influence the clinician decision to propose to treatment option of consist of clinical factor and non-clinical factors. Nevertheless, the relative importance of this is understudied, and the relationship between either factor depend on the type of treatment. This prompts to the question as to why or which factor influence dentist decision to select tooth autotransplantation as one of the chosen treatment. Given that no previous study investigate factor related to the dentist and patient decision to select this treatment, this study aims to be the first and fully approach the dentist as they are the starter of the decision-making process. To engage this aim, this study will survey the associated factor and trend in deciding to propose to autotransplant option to the patient. Material and method. In terms of research design, the proposed study will employ a cross-sectional study by using a questionnaire via Google Form. The initial questionnaire was created and modified before being subject to tests of reliability and validity. The questionnaire was developed based on their feedback from three experts so as to ensure a varied questionnaire design. The link of questionnaire was randomly sent to group of dentists in line application. The data collection from all respondents was done after sending the link for 1 month. The sample size was 30 practicing dentists for a pilot study. The questionnaire comprised 6 sections. I would like to briefly discuss the content and design of each section in this questionnaire. The first section will ask for demographic data. Following this, the participant will approach two case scenarios which ask them to indicate three treatment options for replacing the single edentulite area by ranking in order to preference. This is done so as to get a baseline on non-biased preference with information on tooth autotransplantation. The third section will further delve into background in tooth autotransplantation in terms of education, training, observation, and practicing, and the type of proposal style of participants. The fourth section will ask about the reasoning of dentist decision making with open-end answer. The fifth section will ask about exploration effects of knowledge about tooth autotransplantation, such as indication, procedure, and outcomes, with choosing a Likert score of 1 to 10. The final section provides participants to opportunity to recommend and feedback. Result and discussion. This slide shows the value of content validity and reliability assessment. The response rate was 25.8% from the result, a total of 31 respondents to the paid pilot study compiled a largely female audience with a mean age of 33.77 years and 9.65 years of experience, with mainly a general dentist working in public hospital. From all of the options offered from dentists in both case scenario, the comparison between tooth autotransplant and other choice is shown in this figure. According to the outcome from this study, approximately 10% of tooth autotransplantation was offered when compared with other options. The data show that tooth autotransplantation is not popular as much as others. The background in tooth autotransplantation and type of proposal style are shown in this table. This data show that few dentists have ever done tooth autotransplantation. The result can be grouped into three associated factors: dentist-related factor, patient-related factor, and treatment-related factor. This pilot study has the result that similar to the previous study for proposal other option. As I mentioned, we gather the result why the dentist proposed or not proposed to autotransplantation to the patient from this study, but the limitation of open-end study which cannot be statistically analyzed and conclude that which is the exact cause. This section should be modified and designed to analyze each factor separately in further study. Effects about tooth autotransplantation. This part shows the lack of having up-to-date knowledge about tooth autotransplantation. For example, not many dentists know some donor tooth have a chance revascularization after transplant, and the survival rate of tooth autotransplantation is more than 90%. But the defect of this table is the contradictory of the sentence, which makes it able to analyze properly. The limitation of this study are the small sample size because of this pilot survey and the lacking variability of participants due to access of questionnaire. So the accessibility of the questionnaire should be easy for all general dentists, such as Facebook link or Facebook page. For benefit of this study, first, the design of case scenario in section 2 modified from the previous associated study, we stimulate the planning process like a clinical situation. Second, the data show satisfaction of content validity and reliability assessment. However, it's a small number of tooth autotransplantation may occur from for more than one cause. There are three possible causes. For example, dentists do not offer tooth autotransplantation as one of the options to the patient. Patients do not choose tooth autotransplantation as a final treatment, and in fact that there are few suitable cases for tooth autotransplantation. So this issue needs to explore in the further study. For conclusion, from the pilot study, the results show that there are three factors associated with the dentist decision making to propose tooth autotransplantation as option for replacing in single edentulous area, with a patient-related factor, dentist-related factor, and treatment-related factor. However, this questionnaire can be used to determine which factor are able to influence the dentist to realize that tooth autotransplantation is one of the effective treatment for the patient, and also can clarify the result. Clarify the reason why the dentist would or would not choose tooth autotransplantation as the treatment option. For the further study, these two will be simplified and developed from this pilot feedback in order to review which factor influence the dentist decision to recommend to auto transplantation to the patient and highlight current information gap that could influence whether the dentist decision was limited. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you for your presentation. Is there any audience have the question?
Yes, I have the question.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Well, it's very good presentation. So I have one question. How can you know that the participant that joined your questionnaire is actually a real dentist because you sent it into the Facebook page? Yeah.
In my opinion, for this problem, we can create some question that only dentist knows. For example, like a name of dental instrument or name of dental material like that to initial screen that the participant is the real dentist.
Thank you so much.
That means you already screened the participant already before they continue with your questionnaire, right? Have you done for this research?
Again, please, sorry.
I mean for this research, this questionnaire, you already used the screening question for the dentist who able to come to finish your question, right? Already done or not yet?
Not yet, because it is pilot study. I sent to the like application that I know that all people in that group is dentist.
That means this study have been done in selected participants confirmed to be a dentist.
Yes.
Okay. Is there any other question? I mean the topic is interesting, okay, and we haven't seen any research about this topic before too, but the question is something like where the participant is, the education, the center they stay, right, and the specialists they are, or their interest, are these factor has been analyzed with the result?
For the result, just a survey in pilot study, but cannot compare between factor that it factor influence more among factor.
Okay, so to improve the strength of this study, what will you do?
For the further study, I think in section four that survey about the reason why dentists propose on a postcode, I think it should be group the reason to like a separate factor. Dentist related factor, patient related factor, and treatment related factor, and let the participants shoot, and then I think it can analyze better than open in answer in the pilot.
1 minute left.
Okay, and another is because it's wide range of factor that affect the result, like if you ask the student or you ask in the participant in the training center, you ask the participant in another province, the result should be different. Even the dentist age, like for before 40, 50, 60, their regular practice is different, right? So I think this is a good topic, and the concern is scope to the target participant, then you will interpret more. I mean, the result will be stronger when you present it. And this is a good topic, really. I also wonder why one time the tooth transplantation, auto tooth transplantation is very popular, and then it seems like disappear for a while.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It shouldn't be like that. And I think the people may not know the indication, the proper indication, and it will be what you present, the time point is significant for this treatment option. Okay. Then if there is no more question, I thank you very much to share this and join us for this oral presentation session. Thank you.
Thank you, Hada.